Rafael Murillo, and I attended Seward County Community College. I really enjoyed my time there with the instructors. My instructors was Mike McCarthy, Jose, and Manuel, the people that assist him. And I really enjoyed the fact how hands-on that the environment was. We were pretty much two people to a truck. A lot of experience that, in my opinion, we were at least had the basics to be out on the field with a little more hands-on training on the highway and stuff. But when it came to backing and shifting and the basic stuff, we had a good concept down. Prior to changing my career, I was a salary member of management for a different company. And I was there for 10 years, moved up the ladder until I just felt like I needed something different where I could kind of have a hold of my own future and not have nobody there telling me exactly what I had to do. You manage yourself daily and you're responsible for your own success. As of last year, I believe the law changed, so now to get your CDL, you do have to go to truck driving school. Not to brag on Seward County Community College, but the amount of hands-on training and the one-on-one you spend with the instructors really sets you ahead of the rest. The class is small and more focused on the students rather than just pushing numbers. I graduated Friday and I was on a plane to Irving, Texas on Saturday. I'm going through orientation class that Monday and been there for the last 6 months and enjoying it. I had talked to a couple other carriers that had been very vague and didn't really go into details. When I started asking questions, they would kind of turn me back around and go back to just being very vague. I spent about 2.5-3 hours on the phone with Rick Ham, and we discussed a lot of details. And one thing that really interested me was the fact that they would pay for my tuition and schooling books as long as I committed to driving for a year. Like I said, I've been here 6 months and it seems like I just started yesterday. And my starting rate here at National Carriers, I was already taking home weekly what I would take home working for the other company in 2 weeks. And that's with just the weeks of training that I had. So I average around 2,600 to 3,100 miles a week. The thing that I thought was awesome was that you get paid while you're in training. There's a lot of other places that don't pay you. It's a little buffer to get you going until you start making more money.